In this section, we're going to learn how to add and subtract rational expressions. For example, a question like this, where we are adding and subtracting three rational expressions. So before we do this, let's do a quick review and sharpen up our skills on adding and subtracting fractions. So let's start with an easy example, where we are adding and subtracting three fractions and they happen to have the same denominator, right? Now we know this is the easy case, because whenever we are adding and subtracting fractions with common denominators, we can simply combine all the fractions into one fraction with the common denominator. In this case, the common denominator is 7. Now, for numerators, all we have to do is combine all the numerators together. So we have 3 plus 8 minus 1. Right? That's it. So now, so denominator is 7. Numerator, 3 plus 8, 11 minus 1, we get 10. And that's it. The answer is 10 over 7. We're done. Simple as that. Now, to add and subtract fractions with different denominators. For example, in this question, we have three different denominators, right? 8, 12, and 3. Well, obviously, the first thing we have to do is what? Convert each fraction to the common denominator, right? Because once we have common denominator, we can combine all the fractions together, right? Like what we did for the previous question. So now, how do we find the lowest common denominator? LCD, which stands for lowest common denominator. Well, the method I like to use is called Prime Factorization. Which means we have to find the prime factors for each denominator. So here we have first denominator is 8, second denominator 12, the last denominator 3. Okay. So now, let's start with the first one. So how do you find the prime factorization for 8? Well, 8 is an even number, so it must be divisible by 2, right? And 2 is a prime number, so that's good. So 8 divided by 2, we get 4. Now 4 divided by 2, we get 2. And there we go. The prime factorization for 8 is 2 times 2 times 2. 2 times 2 times 2. Okay? Next. Let's try to find the prime factorization for 12. Divide by 2, we get 6. Divide by 2, we get 3. Done. So the prime factorization for 12 is 2 times 2 times 3. 2 times 2 times 3. You see how when I have the same number, I line them up together. You see why I do this in a bit, okay? Next. For the last denominator, 3. Well, 3 itself is a prime number. So the prime factor for 3 is just 3. And once again, I line up the same numbers, okay? All right, guys. So now we are ready to find the lowest common denominator. So lowest common denominator. So being a denominator, that's common. See, common. That's common to everybody. Then you have to take everybody into consideration. Right? Then you become common to everybody. So now that means we have to, the lowest common denominator must take every prime factor into consideration. So here we have a prime factor of 2. Next, here we have another prime factor of 2. And here we have 2. And here we have another prime factor of 3. See? once you take everybody into consideration, at the end, you become common to all the denominators, right? There we go, guys. So the lowest common denominator in this case will be 2 times 2 times 2 times 3, which is 24. There we go, guys. So the lowest common denominator for these three denominators would be 24. Right? Yeah. Pretty cool, right? Now, because of course, there are a bunch of different ways out there to find lowest common denominator. This is just my personal favorite, okay? Now, hey guys, so now that we know the lowest common denominator is 24, then we know, guys, what we are trying to achieve is convert every fraction to the common denominator, which is 24. Okay, guys? 24 and 24. See, three fractions, convert each one of them to the common denominator, right? Okay, guys? Next. Well, guys, so now let's look at the first fraction here. The original denominator is 8. Now you have to convert it to what? 24. Guys, from 8 to 24, you must multiply by 3. So the bottom, multiply by 3. And of course, you have to be fair, the top, you also got to multiply by 3. Right? Because multiply by 3 over 3, guys, if a number multiplied by 3 over 3, well, 3 over 3 itself is actually just what? 1, right? See, 3 over 3 itself is actually just 1. And any number multiplied by 1, guys, we are not making any changes, right? Okay? Yeah, so you gotta remember, to be fair, if the bottom multiplied by a number, the top, you have to multiply by the same number. Okay? Good. Yeah. So that's good. So now, so that means numerator now we have 5 times 3, which is 15. See? Cool. And then denominator, once again, is 8 times 3, which is 24. Which is what we are trying to achieve, right? Yeah. Next. For the second fraction here, the original denominator is 12. Now you have to convert the denominator to the common denominator, which is 24. So from 12 to 24, we need to multiply by what? 2, right? So you gotta be fair, the top also multiplied by 2. Okay, so now the numerator we have 13 times 2, which is 26. Okay, last. Now, for the last fraction right here, the original denominator is 3. Now we have to convert the denominator to 24. So from 3 to 24, we must multiply by 8. And once again, the top, you gotta be fair, multiply by the same number, 8. Okay, so now in the numerator, we have 1 times 8, which is 8. And guys, don't forget about the sign, okay? So here we have subtraction, and here we have addition, right? All right, guys. Now look at this again. Is this cool or what? Now we have three fractions with the common denominator. See, with the same denominator, 24. Now, are we ready to combine all fractions together? Yes. So now the common denominator is 24. And now we simply have to put all the numerator together. So we have 15 minus 26 plus 8 and 8. All right, guys? Beautiful. So the final answer is denominator 24, and the numerator we have 15 minus 26 plus 8. We have negative 3, right? Okay, guys? And guys, just be careful. Between 3 and 24, do they have any common factor? Yes, they are both divisible by 3. So divide by 3, we get 1. Divide by 3, on the bottom, we get 8. So the final answer is negative 1 over 8. That's it. Okay? Now that you guys have a good idea how to work with the algebra, let me show you another way to do this question. The idea is exactly the same. However, I personally prefer this way because presentation-wise, it's nicer. It's very clean. Let me show you how it works. So guys, by using the prime factorization method, we were able to find the LCD, the lowest common denominator, to be 24, right? Now, for the numerator, this is how I want you to set it up. First numerator, 5. Put a bracket right next to it. The second numerator, negative 13. So guys, remember, you have to take the sign into consideration. So negative 13, once again, put a bracket right next to it. The last numerator, positive 1. Put a bracket right next to it. Next. So guys, to convert the first denominator, 8, to the common denominator, 24, we need to multiply by 3. Okay? Cool. Next. To convert the second denominator, 12, to the common denominator, 24, we need to multiply by 2. Put it right here. Cool? Next. To convert the last denominator, 3, to the common denominator, 24, we need to multiply by 8. Put that right here. And we're done. Check this out, guys. So 24. So the numerator now we have 5 times 3, 15. And then negative 13 times 2, we have negative 26. Positive 1 times 8, we have positive 8. Okay? So denominator 24, numerator 15 minus 26 plus 8, we have negative 3. And both numerator and denominator, they are divisible by 3. So divide by 3, we get 1. Divide by 3, we get 8. So the final answer is negative 1 over 8, right? So of course, we expect to arrive at the same answer. However, I want to compare the presentation. Guys, would you say this is very clean? Very nice, right? See, compared to this, where you have to write, right next to the original question, you have to write 3 over 3, 2 over 2, 8 over 8. This is a little bit messy, right? But this is very nice. And that's why I prefer it this way.